Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Tuesday, the 19th of May. Coronavirus infections surged past 100,000 in India, deaths topped 3,000. Pakistan reports over 1,800 new COVID-19 cases, total nears 44,000. And Afghans struggle amid pandemic, facing livelihood challenges. And now for all the details. India's coronavirus cases tally surged past 100,000 on Tuesday, with over 3,160 deaths reported so far. This comes as the country has eased restrictions, allowing businesses to reopen and public transport to ply as part of the fourth phase of the lockdown. Coronavirus cases in India reached 101,139 on Tuesday as the country reported 4,970 new cases over the last 24 hours, with total 3,163 deaths reported so far. India's death rate has been less than that of some other big countries at nearly 3% compared to the US and Britain. This comes as India has entered into its fourth phase of coronavirus lockdown until May 31st, with considerable relaxations allowing several businesses to reopen.
मरीजों की संख्या बढ़ना हमारे लिए उतनी चिंता की बात नहीं है, जितना कि हम सघन रूप से उसका जो ट्रेसिंग कर लेते हैं और उसके जितना ट्रेसिंग अच्छा होगा जिस क्षेत्र में, वहां जल्दी ही उस पर हम अंतिम निर्णय कर पाएंगे.
Meanwhile, Indian capital New Delhi and some other state governments have ordered the reopening of public transport amid the lockdown. On Tuesday, auto rickshaws, buses, taxis returned to New Delhi streets but with restrictions and have been told to take precautionary measures. The lockdown imposed in India since March 24th has hit the incomes of millions of workers and left businesses without revenues. Although lockdown curbs have been eased, air travel and most public gatherings remain restricted. Two terrorists of Pakistan-based Hizbul Mujahideen terror group were killed in a gun battle with security forces in India's Jammu and Kashmir on Tuesday. The operation began around midnight following a tip-off about the presence of the terrorists.
Two terrorists belonging to Pakistan-based Hizbul Mujahideen terrorist group were killed in an encounter in Nawakdal area in Srinagar city of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Tuesday. The encounter between the terrorists and a joint team of police and paramilitary forces broke out on the intervening night of Monday and Tuesday as the security forces launched search and cordon operations in Nawakdal upon specific inputs. One person of Jammu and Kashmir police was also injured in the encounter, a police spokesperson said.
पिछली रात का जो ऑपरेशन है इसमें दो टेररिस्ट मारे गए हैं और दोनों की पहचान हमारे पास आ गई. एक तो श्रीनगर शहर से ही है, जुनेद अशरफ खान, और दूसरा पुलवामा से है, तारिक अहमद शेख.
Indian security forces have stepped up search operations in Kashmir Valley in recent days, claiming Pakistan continues to infiltrate terrorists from across the border to spread unrest on Indian soil even at the time of coronavirus pandemic. In a major victory for the armed forces, a top commander of Hizbul Mujahideen, Riaz Naiku, was killed in an encounter in Jammu and Kashmir on May 6.
Pakistan reported 1,841 new cases of the novel coronavirus during the last 24 hours, taking the total infections in the country to nearly 44,000 with 939 deaths. As the country battles its fight against the pandemic, Prime Minister Imran Khan said his government will donate 4 rupees for every rupee donated to the COVID-19 relief fund.
The number of confirmed COVID-19 cases in Pakistan rose to 43,966 on Tuesday, after new infections were confirmed in the country. The virus has claimed at least 939 lives, while at least 12,489 coronavirus patients have recovered. Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan, taking to Twitter on Tuesday, said his government will contribute rupees 4 to every rupee donated in COVID-19 relief fund. Khan had on Monday launched the disbursement process of the SR's emergency cash program funded by Prime Minister's COVID relief fund to benefit those who lost employment as a consequence of the coronavirus pandemic. Meanwhile, the Supreme Court of Pakistan questioned the authorities on Tuesday regarding the provision of facilities at the coronavirus quarantine centers across the country and observed that they are not performing to their maximum potential. Pakistan's Attorney General Khalid Javed Khan said that due to the court's recent order to reopen shopping malls and small markets, the officials are now facing difficulty in implementation of measures. The apex court subsequently adjourned the hearing until June 8th.
Moving on, as authorities of Gilgit district in illegally occupied Gilgit-Baltistan region have restricted movement amid coronavirus outbreak, residents of adjoining areas are facing problems. Locals said they are not being allowed to visit even hospitals in case of emergencies.
People living in adjoining areas of Gilgit district in Pakistan-occupied Gilgit-Baltistan are facing problems due to movement restrictions at the border imposed amid coronavirus pandemic. Locals complained that even those wanting to visit hospitals and are really sick are not being allowed to enter Gilgit district, due to which they are facing a lot of problems.
आपका सुल्तानाबाद चेक पोस्ट पे हमें रोका जा रहा है. हम डिस्ट्रिक्ट निगर से आए हुए हैं, तो हमारे मरीज चेक कराने आए हैं, तो यहाँ हमारे लिए परेशानी का बायस है. तो गवर्नमेंट के रिट का हम एहतराम करते हैं, ऐसी बात नहीं है. यहाँ का डिस्ट्रिक्ट मजिस्ट्रेट अगर कोई ऑर्डर करता है तो फिर एक डिस्ट्रिक्ट हमारे पास भी है, डिस्ट्रिक्ट नगर, फिर वहाँ हमें भी बंद करना होगा, फिर हंगामी हालत सूरत पैदा होगी.
द रेजिडेंट्स ऑफ नियर बाई डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स ऑफन ट्रैवल फॉर वर्क, विजिट हॉस्पिटल्स एंड बाय एसेंशियल्स इन मार्केट्स इन गिलगित डिस्ट्रिक्ट. They claimed they are not being properly informed about the government policies in the wake of coronavirus outbreak, which is creating problems like traffic jam at the Gilgit border. Gilgit-Baltistan as of Tuesday reported 550 cases of the novel coronavirus. Locals have been raising concern over the region's poor healthcare infrastructure for years. They say the region is ill-equipped to tackle the pandemic.
In news from Afghanistan, to contain the epidemic, Afghan government has also imposed daytime curfew on cities, urging people to stay at home. With the lockdown in place, residents in Mazar-e-Sharif city are struggling and facing livelihood challenges. Mazar-e-Sharif, like other cities in Afghanistan, has been under a lockdown over the past several weeks and people are rarely allowed to go out. The spread of the novel coronavirus in conflict-battered Afghanistan has added to the poverty of impoverished locals. To contain the epidemic, the government, besides banning public gatherings and conferences, shutting down schools and universities, has also imposed daytime curfew on cities, urging people to stay at home. With the lockdown in place, residents continue to struggle and face livelihood challenges. Masuma, mother of six, started doing embroidery at home and selling her products to overcome the economic challenges.
ما خود در خانه نگه بداریم و هم خود و امضای خانواده خود و اقاربی که در چهار اطراف ماست اونا را از این آفاتی که خلق شده چی کنیم نجات بدیم.
The spike in food prices, which has come in the Muslim month of Ramadan, is a harsh blow for residents, especially daily wage workers. The government of Afghanistan has announced packages of humanitarian assistance, including distribution of naan or flatbread, to help needy families across the country during the lockdown.
Several of world's biggest fashion brands and retailers have cancelled orders for clothes, bags and shoes worth billions of dollars from Asian garment factories, including in Bangladesh, amid coronavirus outbreak. The situation has made long-term survival of garment factories and workers uncertain.
As stores closed across Europe and the United States in March and April, in response to the coronavirus outbreak, many fashion brands and retailers have cancelled orders for the clothes, bags and shoes worth billions of dollars from Asian garment factories, including in Bangladesh. After a public outcry, some Western companies have agreed to pay for orders that have already been shipped or are in production. Others ask for discounts or have delayed payment, leaving suppliers struggling to stay afloat and making long-term survival of garment factories uncertain. More than 500 garment factories in Bangladesh that supply to global brands had reopened on April 27th amid a coronavirus lockdown. Bangladesh is home to around 4,000 garment factories employing 4.1 million workers. Industry groups for the sector had warned that the shutdown that began on March 26 could cause the country to lose $6 billion in export revenue this financial year. Bangladesh reported 23,870 coronavirus cases as of Tuesday, of whom 349 have died.
As Cyclone Amphan intensified into a supercyclonic storm and it's spiraling towards Indian shores, governments of West Bengal and Odisha provinces started evacuating people from the coastal belts. Amphan is expected to make landfall on West Bengal coast on May 20th as an extremely severe cyclonic storm.
India began evacuating thousands of people and halted port operations ahead of Cyclone Amphan, expected to hit its east coast this week, piling pressure on emergency services grappling with the coronavirus pandemic. The extremely severe cyclonic storm Amphan has now turned into a supercyclonic storm and is spiraling towards Indian shores. The cyclone expected to make landfall on Wednesday comes as India eases the world's longest lockdown imposed in March against the virus, which has infected more than 100,000 people. The supercyclonic storm is only the second over the Bay of Bengal in two decades. The National Disaster Response Force has deployed 37 teams in the coastal areas of West Bengal and Odisha provinces.
अभी फिलहाल 15 टीम उड़ीसा में हैं, जो कि deployed हैं और जमीन पर काम शुरू कर चुकी हैं, awareness drive का, communication का और evacuation का. 19 टीमें West Bengal में ground पर हैं और दो टीमें West Bengal में reserve में हैं.
Authorities at the port of Paradip in Odisha ordered ships to move out to sea to avoid damage as the cyclone approached. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Monday held a meeting in capital New Delhi to plan how to mitigate damage and injuries.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. Coronavirus infection surge past 100,000 in India, deaths top 3,000. Pakistan reports over 1,800 new COVID-19 cases, total nears 44,000. An Afghan struggle amid pandemic facing livelihood challenges. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.